Welcome, Flyers fans. You're listening to Chris Mayer, Flyers Fan Mania 93 on YouTube.
Alright, what is up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Chris, and today I'm back with the end of the World Juniors video here. One thing I wanted to point out is I just finished editing the latest video for the Switzerland and Russia game in Brian Zanetti. I know the audio is a little, it's a little iffy right now. I understand that it's kind of a little bit of an echo. I do apologize for that. It's going to be fixed very soon. I had to order a couple things to fix the tech issue that I'm having with that, so bear with me for this video. It should be the last one where I have that issue, but I can't make any promises. I'm not the biggest tech guy. I do apologize for that. I'm still trying to work some kinks out with this whole new system and the whole tech thing that I kind of have going on here. But this game, Sweden versus Slovakia. Jesper Wallstedt was the biggest story in this game. 48 saves, 48 save shutout. Slovakia is a very, very underrated team this tournament, I think. They had a pretty good game last night, against the United States, and they only lost that game 3-2. And penalties hurt them in that game. Penalties gave up the first goal of this game for Sweden. They didn't play their best game overall. I thought Emil Andrae was very good, which is the whole reason why I'm covering this. As for Sweden, it definitely was not their best game that they could have played. But as for Andrae, he was fantastic. I mentioned before, he had good gap control. Two things I've noticed from him in the games that I've watched already, he's had good gap control, and he's had really good plays just getting the puck through the net. Literally in the opening shift, he had a quick shot to turn it on a head take, got chippy with a Slovakian player going to the bench, tossed a couple jabs back and forth. Those are the things I love from Andrae. Slovakia had a chance here in the first period early on a slot shot, ended up going high. Andrae had a really smart play on almost 2-1. If he doesn't know it was a Slovakian player, it's a clear 2-1, that could have been a goal. So he basically holds him off, got away with it, which it happens. Most guys do, a lot of guys commit penalties, and the refs call everything. There'll be 400 million penalties in the game, so I feel like a lot of that stuff is, everybody does it. It's just kind of what the ref sees kind of thing, and that's kind of a play that you got away with, and it was a smart play, because if he doesn't take that, and he doesn't hold that guy off, it's a clear cut 2-1, it could be in the back of your net, you could be finding yourself down 1-0, so I thought it was a pretty smart play there, and it's a really good power play, and then they score very similar to the old school against Russia. Andrae down low, quick pass in front, over, and it was a goal. This play was just quick, bam, right to the box, one-timer goes high, and it's 1-0 Sweden. So Slovakia, regardless of being down nothing, they had a lot of good chances at more territorial play and shots. Shots were 7-2 Slovakia around the 11-minute mark of this period. Andrae with another good play on gap control on the 3-on-2 rush, forced a low-quality outside shot instead of maybe a high-quality chance off of maybe, pass down low, where it definitely kind of pitches up and they get through and get them marshaled to 1-8 close, or kind of things like that. So I thought he had a really good first period overall. It was 1-0 Sweden. After one, a couple power plays for both teams, a couple chances for both as well. Andrae was on the second unit power play. He had more special teams time in this game. I know he did the power play in the first game, but he had more special teams time playing on the penalty kill, which played a big factor late in the game. I'll talk about that in a little bit. Second period starts. Andrae had a really smart play on the 2-1. He just stayed in the middle on the Slovakian forward that was going to the net. That player that had the puck on the left wall going down was left-handed, so that made more sense for him to kind of stay on that side because, a lefty, a righty has more of a better angle to shoot than a lefty going on the left wall, so that was a smart play there. And also, on the same shift, had a nice breakup pass that led to a chance on the net. It led to a chance that went to the net on that same shift. So really good shift there, good defense, led to good offense, good breakup pass. It was kind of a play where pass up the winger, center of the net, and went for a tip, ended up going high and hit the glass. Andrae then again just throwing into the net. He's put down here, had a really good job of just getting shots through. And he did that for most of this game. The 2-0 Sweden, they score basically a play to turn nothing. Soderberg would just kind of drag it through the legs of his Slovakian defender and just kind of go right around and shoot on the blocker side and score, so 2-0 there. Slovakia still put on a bunch of pressure. Holds end up hitting Andrae in the slot, but he blew them the puck.
and he tried to spit it in front of them, and getting flipped away. So third period. Basically, it was a pretty even game until Isaiah on the 11 mark. He had the big hit by Lou for the match penalty. And it's a 5-minute power play. So
Andrae has a failed clear and getting blocked. Blocked a shot on that right.
Then there's a delay game for Sweden with around a minute 10 left on the 5-minute major.
So they already had a 5-minute power play. They killed him with that Andrae had a blocked shot there.
Slovakia also pulled a goaltender, which is such a bold move by the coach. I love it because I thought they played a great game. And you might as well. So they pulled the goalie, which was around like 8 minutes left, by the way. And they were only down 2-0. And they pulled the goalie. So they pulled the goalie, didn't get anything, they get the delay game, 5-1-3. Andrae had a block shot on Kromiak, another one.
Hit five total blocks on the penalty kill.
In the past, like, maybe 5-6 minutes of the period. Four of them on Kromiak and the high slot. Just either one he got a piece of, the one he dove down in front. I believe that six block shots in this game from my eyes. He had a great defensive effort on one where he kind of just dove right in front of it. Just great play, and Sweden ended up getting an empty net goal coming later, make it 3-0. And, Wallstedt was fantastic. And Andrae with four block shots, that was huge on that penalty kill. Absolutely huge for them. And it was awesome to see the captain of the team kind of like that, just kind of put his body in front of the line. It was just awesome to see. So overall, I thought he had a really solid game against Sweden. I guess you could say kind of surprised because if it wasn't for Wallstedt, they probably wouldn't win that game. And I thought for Andrae, in his sake, I thought he had a really, really solid game. And the four block shots are in the past, basically all in the same shift, which is unbelievable. So if you did check out this game, then you guys will blow him right again. I do apologize for the audio. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to check out Buttons and Garrett Group Construction for Buttons. You use code PHAC for 10% off Garrett Group Construction for any home improvement needs. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll talk to you all again soon.